welcome everybody. Can you hear me? All right. Well, welcome to our Elizabeth Peratrovich Day celebration. Can you give a hand for this awesome day? We're here to celebrate the pioneering of a civil rights leader. This is an amazing day we get to do together. We're glad you're all here, and we're going to have a great day today. Shagao yua hut dua salk, Tlingit hinach, yang yin di nahut sati, dak dang tan ayahut, gunas chish. My name is Nathan Lopez. My Tlingit name is Shagao. I am Eagle Wolf, yang yin di of the Taku people of Hitlain. My father was Mike Lopez, kashtu ashish, and his clan was dak dang tan. My grandmother was Ethel Lopez, Wukustin. My great-grandfather was Pete Martin, Sakudin. My great-great-grandfather was Tutsu Gamber Bay Jim. My last name Lopez comes from my grandfather, Arturo Lopez, who came from Colombia, South America, came all the way to the United States, fell in love with a Tlingit woman, and moved to Petersburg. They didn't know each other's language. She whipped him into shape, Tlingit woman. And that's how our family started here in Petersburg. My mom, Janice Lopez side, comes from Oregon and settled in Wrangell, and they're the McMurns from there. I'm a mix of Scottish and European. I'm proud of all of who I am. Let's be proud of who we are, right?
Yes.
I have an amazing wife, Mindy, and three awesome kids. Kasaya, Cadence, and Davin. I'm a Petersburg Tlingit and HITA delegate, PIA tribal citizen, and a pastor in town. I'm blessed and honored to MC today. It's awesome that we get to gather to do this in celebration of Elizabeth Peratrovich. Elizabeth Peratrovich saw the injustice of how she and other natives were being treated. What if she had decided to be silent and just let current state of treatment continue? In this very town, there were signs on our businesses that said, no dogs, no natives. How different would our lives be if she and many others didn't stand up? Elizabeth was born right here in Petersburg, and she had a fight in her to stand for what is right. Elizabeth Peratrovich and Amy Hallingstad were great examples to others like Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. of what is possible when we get up and stand up for our God-given rights. How different would our country be if she didn't inspire other civil rights leaders? Amy Hallingstad wrote in a letter, "With God's help, we still hope that what our parents passed on to us, we may in turn pass on to our children and to our children's children forever." Martin Luther King Jr. wrote, "Our lives begin to end the day we become silent about things that matter." Today, we celebrate Elizabeth Peratrovich and her stand for things that matter. Welcome to this Elizabeth Peratrovich Day celebration. At this time, we would like to welcome our Tlingit neighbors from Wrangell as they come and sing. It's the Wrangell J.O.M. and Elders Dancers. So can we welcome them, please, as they come forward?
Yeah. city wa tenedi aya khat kikh kwan da khaya khat khat khnak tso ki kasego akhsaye tso. We're the Wrangell J.O.M. Kasatlan dancers and shkat kwan. The song you heard us singing outside was an outside song, an outside paddle song, letting you know we're coming. Gunath chish, ganta yak sidi, gunath chish, atlang, for letting us be here with you. We really appreciate celebrating Elizabeth Peratrovich Day. And our dancers here are going to be hosting the celebration 2020 up at Juneau, Alaska, Occoquan. We're going to be singing those songs that you just heard us sing. We're so proud and nice to see Larissa here in Petersburg. They call your town Guntiyuk City because of those masts out there, all those boats in the harbor. Okay, that was the outside song. We entered on the entrance song. We're going to do a chief's welcome for you. We're practicing. Bear with us. Ladies, hold back, boys up front. Turn girls, not boys, but girls, please turn.
Away, yeah.
lot of collaboration with the Arts Council and the local A&S, Joe and Barb. Thank you so much, and Malene, and Janine?
Yeah.
I recognized her by her photos up here, her pictures. Yay. Yes, and other people too. Who else am I forgetting? I do that. Forgive
me. That's good.
You've got a good list. Okay. All right. So then we'd like to do this song. Men, can you fall back? And we want Lorraine to come up front.
Whoa.
Lorraine is the A&S president, and she's also
a nungan.
And also the two girls, please, Jeigh. They're going to dance a little bird dance for you. Gook, she cut up with.
Yeah.
what an incredible tribute that we can do this in memory of Elizabeth Peratrovich. Isn't this an amazing day? It's amazing that we got her together. And that's what she fought for. She fought for all of us to have our rights. Such an amazing thing. Such an amazing time that we get to gather together to do that. And today, we have many people that we would like to honor to come forward and to share a welcome with all of us. And at this time, I would love to welcome one of our elders here in our community. If we could welcome forward Ray Duguqua as he comes forward. Such an amazing guy, such a great heart. Many, many great stories. If you have a chance, make sure that you're able to spend some time with Ray. He has lots of great stories, and so we're honored to hear from you, Ray. Thank you for sharing with us this afternoon. It's hard to hear our language and tears to not well from my eyes. It's what I grew up with from my mom, my grandma Sean, Doris Nanick, and Martha James, and many others. I remember they would look at each other, and I'd be sitting down playing with toys, and they'd be talking Tlingit to each other, and then they'd look over at me, and they'd be talking Tlingit, look over at me, and start laughing. Like, that's not fair, I don't know what you're saying. But it's such an awesome thing for us to be able to have our elders here and some that still speak our language. And we are praying for a revitalization of our language for our people. Well, at this time, we're able to hear from our Borough Assembly member, Ray J. Stanton-Gregor. If you could come forward, can we give him a welcome as he comes and welcomes us to our borough. Thank you, Jeigh.
As was stated, my name is Jay Stanton-Gregor, and I'm humbled and honored to be sharing this day with all of you. Several nights ago, I was trying to describe to my three-year-old daughter, Margot, who Elizabeth Peratrovich was, in a way that a three-year-old would understand. After talking, and her listening, and making faces, she blurts out loudly, "Daddy, I want to be just like her when I grow up. She is so strong." And my eight-year-old son, Silas, jumps in. So I repeat parts of the story. "Oh yeah, that's who I need to be when I grow up too." It's a true story, and it's a great reminder for me. Right? Absolutely. Truth be told, it brought tears to my eyes because we want our children to have great role models. And Elizabeth Peratrovich was a great role model and still is to all of us. I thank you again and welcome to you all.
Is Sue Paulson here? Okay, well, I can't forget Sue Paulson. It's kind of hard to forget you, right? Can we welcome one of our elders in town as well? Can we welcome Sue Paulson? Thank you.
Great. Nathan and Jay have all said, "Velkommen." That's what we have to say. We also have to say, "Mangatak." To the PIA, to the ANS, to the ANB, for inviting everyone to this celebration. Was part of a river of immigrants, my grandparents among them, that left Norway for a better life about 1900. In 1898, Bushmen came up Wrangell Narrows, located a trade and manufacturing site, and organized the Icy Strait Packing Company to start a salmon cannery. He sent his son August and a native man named Paul from Ketchikan ashore to build the first cabin to validate that claim right here on the shores of Wrangell Narrows. Bushmen had seen that this tip of Mitkoff Island was ideal for a cannery, for a settlement. It had a good harbor, ice, lumber, fish, things the Tlingit people already knew as they had been here for thousands of years. The bumper sticker says it all. Tlingit Fish Camp, 2,000 years. Norwegian Salmon Cannery, 100 years. Looking back, it seems symbolic that a Norwegian and a native Alaskan started construction here that year, as many of them would settle and build the community we know today, assisted as time went on by people of just about every heritage. The last 120 years has seen a lot of growth and change in our community, and the impact of Elizabeth Peratrovich and her achievements in civil rights has been monumental. It's an honor to join in the celebration. So, thank you, and onward.
Thank you, Ms. Paulson. At this time, we'd like to welcome from Petersburg Indian Association from our tribe, our Vice President, Brenda Norheim. Yeah, Brenda.
Good afternoon. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Brenda Norheim, and I am Vice President of Petersburg Indian Association. On behalf of Petersburg Indian Association, I'd like to thank you all for coming out to celebrate Elizabeth Peratrovich Day with us today. 2 years ago, Janine Gibbons and I were talking about Elizabeth Peratrovich and the many accomplishments that she had made, and It just kind of blossomed. From that, we got together and thought, well, maybe you should do a great painting, maybe just put it in the window and kind of educate people about it. And so she did. Janine went home, and the very next day, she produced this painting overnight of Elizabeth Peratrovich. And there we had a little gathering here at the hall and invited the public, and we had some of you out there were here. It was a nice little gathering, and we unveiled the painting, and to say the least, seeing everybody here today is overwhelming. It is so heartwarming from that very day. I know it's very emotional for Janine to see where we are now. We went on from there, and we were talking about her Elizabeth's minted coin that was coming out this year in 2020. And going on, then we just pointed out the great things that Elizabeth had done. She was a woman. She was a Tlingit woman. She was born on the 4th of July in 1911. She was born in Petersburg, Alaska, and Elizabeth was the main driving force to ensure the passing of the Anti-Discrimination Act in 1945. This year we celebrate the 75th anniversary of Alaska's Anti-Discrimination Act, the first anti-discrimination law in the United States. That's huge. We are thrilled to be here today to celebrate Elizabeth and the release of her minted coin. And just everybody sit back and enjoy the show that's here today. Thank you.
Thank you. our A and B and A&S Camp 16. We have them to be able to come forward. Let's welcome Barbara Erickson and Joseph Stewart as well. We have the A&S first Grand Vice President that's here as well, Sandy Churchill. Can we welcome all three of them as they come forward? And welcome from A and B and A&S.
My name is Barbara Erickson. I am the president of Camp 16 A&S. To my right is Joe Stewart, the president of A and B Camp 16 A&S, or A and B. Sandy Churchill from Wrangell Camp 1, and also the vice president of Grand Camp A&S. This is Colyn Lyons, my cousin, and the grandson of Amy Hallingstad. As A&S Camp 16 President, I welcome you all to this Elizabeth Peratrovich Day celebration. We are all here to honor the great work that Roy and Elizabeth Peratrovich started through the A&B and A&S resolution that was adopted in the 1940s that then got forwarded to Congress by them. According to Dr. Walter Soboloff in the book entitled In Sisterhood, there were signs being posted saying, "No natives allowed." This bothered our native people, so the A&B and A&S took issue with it at a convention. And that's where the movement for anti-discrimination started. The A&B and A&S had to work with the governor. Governor Ernest Gruening was sympathetic to our cause. The discrimination occurring in Alaska wasn't just in Juneau. This attitude affected all of Alaska, all the way up to Nome. In 1979, at a Grand Camp convention held in Juneau, Roy Peratrovich brought forward a resolution establishing an Alaska Native Sisterhood Executive Committee to be made up of past A&S Grand Presidents. This motion passed unanimously. Peratrovich and Dr. Alfred Widmark stopped the convention the moment the resolution was passed and instructed the Sergeant at Arms to set up a table for the A&S Executive Committee on the other side of the A&B Executive Committee. According to Emma Widmark, A&S Executive Committee member and daughter of the late Dr. Alfred Widmark. The guys were scrambling around and my father asked all the A&S Grand Presidents to stand up. All passed. He then asked the Sergeant at Arms to escort them up to the table to be seated with the A&B Grand Presidents. I'm sure the list of these past A&S Grand Presidents include many ladies who fought alongside Elizabeth Peratrovich and carried her cause into this very day. As A&S Camp 16 President, I have to acknowledge the work of our own founding sister, Amy Hallingstad, and her daughter, Gertrude Lyons, who started the A&S in Petersburg. There were many other accomplishments by these two women and many other women and men in our fight for equality. Suffice it to say that what Roy and Elizabeth started could not be finished without the teamwork of all of the men and women of A&B and A&S who carried the torch for Native people of Alaska. I do not want to see our history as A&B and A&S omitted or overlooked. We have had many strong leaders in all the communities of our organization, and Amy and Gertrude stood for and fought for civil rights here in Petersburg. I hope we can all appreciate and acknowledge these names and many others for the work Roy and Elizabeth started in the 1940s. Welcome.
Howdy, everybody.
Howdy.
You know what Barb just read, you know, it's the only thing that is left for me to say. The only thing left for me to say is, you know, this tribe has a lot of leaders. You know, the thing that I want to pay attention to is the mothers, grandmothers, and great-grandmothers of the tribe here. They need to be acknowledged. You know, we talk about the work that Roy and Elizabeth did. Is that work still going? Are we still doing the work? Or are we just talking about it? I feel it's very important that the work continues. So how do we do that? You know, it's very hard to do anything unless we have the input of the tribe. You know, and I feel that's very, very important. Without you guys, we can't do anything. Okay. And you know, I don't want to stand up here and start a political speech. So. And like I say, you know, a lot of what I was going to say has already been covered. But I'm very, very proud to be up here. I'm very proud to recognize, acknowledge Roy and Elizabeth. And I'm also very proud to honor the grandmothers of the sisterhood. You know. It's either words or work. It's one or the other. This is, you know, how are we going to keep this stuff going? You know, some of you might say, well, you're not doing nothing now. No, that's not true. We're doing the very best we can with what we have. Okay. But we all need help. When you ask the leader, you know, where their success comes from, you know, what makes them what they are, you know that the real leaders will give thanks to the people that put them there, which is the tribe, which is you guys. You know. Would you like that?
Suit Sun Tla, you had to a sock, chalk nakatsati. My Tlingit name is Suit Sun Tla, but my English name is Sandy Churchill. And I want to thank you for welcoming Wrangell to your Elizabeth Peratrovich celebration on this day. So, thank you. Could you stand up? And that is our local ANB president, Sam Campus. Lorraine Allen, our Madam President of ANS. And on behalf of Alaska Native Sisterhood Grand Camp and Alaska Native Brotherhood Grand Camp, it's such an honor to be honoring one of our own. And so she worked for positive changes, you know, and positive changes have happened. And it's because of her being strong enough to get up and speak and the support that she got from the people and at the time. And then her speech, of course, Ms. Diane knows her speech very well, that helped pass a law. And then Alaska passing that law to end discrimination. So thank you on behalf of Alaska Grand Camp for honoring Elizabeth.
Well, I just
just want to let you know it was a great thing to honor her, but this is not the hometown of just one leader. Her grandmother, Amy Hallingstad, was a big fighter for the people, and many others that followed her very well know this. And to see these things carry on without too much of a gratitude to her, like the saying goes, sticks and stones might break your bones, but words can never hurt you. But when there's no words in their honor, that hurts you. She stood out like the sunset of past Thomas Bay to the rest of the people. She was a leader. And she fought against segregation just as much, if not more, than anybody in history. Do you know, segregation was still so bad here just two generations before my time that the natives were segregated to their own schools. When her firstborn got old enough to go to school, she changed that. She went to the school board and told them, I've been paying public school tax all my life, and my son's going to your public school. That went. Her son Casper Hollingstead Jr. was the first to serve to go to Petersburg Public School. The rest of us to follow, who broke that segregation, and so many others. She organized unions for the people and the canneries, the coal soldiers, the natives, the Filipinos, Japanese, Chinese, were all being treated so unfair. They had their own segregated bathrooms, coffee rooms. She changed that. She introduced the unions to protect them and give them their equal rights too. There's a whole book I have over here of words and the things that she achieved that goes on to this day with the rest of you is unrecognizing them. That hurts. It's hard to speak at times like this. So I'll just say this, goodness cheese.
John is risen to such a place of leadership in our Tlingit and the CCTHITA tribes, and it is an honor of one of our very own to hold that place as well. He is the next coming hit sahi of the big sakai house of the Dukdang Tong clan. And so we're honored. Can we give an awesome, warm welcome to one of our very own Ware, as he comes and welcome to him.
You know, I grew up with Nathan and his brother, and I was trying to kick him as we were getting going here because he was embellishing so well. It's good to see everybody here. And I do also want to say to our friends and our family from Wrangell. And it means a lot that you guys are here. That's my father's people, my grandfather's people. My grandfather was born in the Stikine River, the Nanyai. And so their house is right there on Chief Shake's Island. And so, it's good to see you here to celebrate with us. It means a lot. Elizabeth Peratrovich Day is one of these few amazing days that we can all celebrate together, corporately, as a whole. It's a day that we can all get together, remember, and memorialize, and celebrate the ideals we should all embrace. I'm not loud enough, huh? Ideals that we embrace regardless of our political standings, whether you lean left or right or center. This is the day that we can all celebrate the human and civil liberties that we all enjoy. Elizabeth Peratrovich Day should also remind us and cause us to appreciate the strength of the cultural diversity that we celebrate in this state, not just in this state, but right here in this community. Elizabeth and Roy Peratrovich were decades ahead of the national movement. And it's exciting to know that it was our own that were breaking glass ceilings, that were breaking the trails for us to have the opportunities that we have now. Today, our people run sophisticated tribes, successful corporations and businesses. And yet, we still live our way of life. Some call it culture, but it's more than that. It's our way of life. I differentiate culture and way of life because our elders, our ancestors, they never called it our culture. Culture adapts and changes according to the social norms of our time. Our way of life is the basis to our culture. Our way of life is unchanging and founded upon the following principles: strength, both physically and emotionally, respect, honor, and even humor, a love and an extensive knowledge of the land and the sea. Our language is being heard again, more and more. Our songs are being remembered and danced to once again. Our art is becoming noticed, recognized, and widely appreciated. We live in a time like no other for our people. And this cannot be overstated enough. It's in large part because of the work of Elizabeth and her husband Roy, and folks indeed like Amy Hallingstad, and early leaders of the AMB and ANS, who stood their ground and fought for the equality of all. I remember growing up and attending the AMB, ANS meetings, and the large potlucks that we'd have right here, and seeing Gertrude taking lead and control, Annie's daughter. Every time you'd go down into the Petersburg Indian Association office, when it was just a small little office down on Main Street, Gertrude was there, and she'd welcome, even when you were just a kid, and you'd walk into the building, she'd welcome you in there. She'd make you feel just at home. You did something wrong, don't get me wrong, she'd let you know. It was our Tlingit way for aunties to correct. And boy, we got corrected. Is there more work yet to be done? Absolutely. But let us just for this moment appreciate the work already done before us. It's good to see everybody here.
Thank you. Well, at this time, we have a song. It's called The Prize, performed by Scott Hursey. We're honored to be able to have him share this afternoon. What a great day for us to get together, to hear stories, to be inspired, to be encouraged in our future. I want to encourage us as we're here. There's a lot of opportunities that we have and will continue to have throughout the year for us to gather together. When you hear of those opportunities, those dinners and gatherings we do, we encourage all of our people in our community to come and support each other. There's lots of other ways to get involved. We had the A&B, A&S come up, so you can get involved with the A&B, A&S. We can attend our PIA tribal meetings. We can be involved with CCTHITA through our delegates. So, Gunashish, I think at this time, Scott Hursey singing The Prize. Thank you, Scott.
Welcome, everybody. Let me do a quick tune-up. The temperature changed a lot in here. Guitars don't like that.
What a day. My name is Scott Hursey. I've been a resident of the hometown of Elizabeth Peratrovich, proud to say that, for 47 years. And it's an honor today to be celebrating this amazing woman. Our little town should be truly honored that the image of one of its own is on going to be on U.S. currency. That's a place that's usually been reserved for presidents and almost exclusively for old white men. I think it's just an awesome thing that she was, you know, one of ours is on the currency. So I wrote this song several years ago, drawing on inspiration from one of the iconic civil rights songs of the 60s. Borrowed a line from it, part of the name. But all new music is in some way derived and takes inspiration from what's come before, just as Elizabeth inspired those that followed her. A lot of people think of Rosa Parks as the mother of civil rights, but Elizabeth was two decades before her. And and Elizabeth would probably say that there were others before her that inspired her. So the song is talks about making your voices heard, standing up for your rights, which is just as important now as it was back then in Elizabeth's day and Rosa Parks' day, because we have a people in power now who are trying to diminish those rights, those hard-won rights. I wrote this song quite a few years ago, and then a few years later, I was asked by a chapter of Amnesty International to enter it in a competition they were having in a contest. I didn't win, but they did ask me to sing it for an online performance of the songs that were entered. And even though I didn't ever get a chance to meet her, I feel like it was inspired by Elizabeth. So anyway, the prize.
Get on your feet and make your voices heard. Don't waste any more time. We've got to tell them we've got something to say. It's time we open their eyes. Don't let those blind people get in your way. Keep your eyes on the prize. Keep your eyes on the prize. We've listened to their lies for way too long. Never believed them anyway. It's time we told them they got to move on. The justice will have its day. It's time we told them we got something to say. It's time we open their eyes. Don't let those blind people get in your way. Keep your eyes on the prize. Keep your eyes on the prize. We've got a chance to make a change in this world. Throw out the wrong and make it right. It's foolish thinking that we'll win making war, but no one wins in that fight. It's time we told them we've got something to say. It's time we open their eyes. Don't let those blind people get in your way. Keep your eyes on the prize. Keep your eyes on the prize. Turning point in the road has come. It's time we made up get on our feet and make our voices heard. But don't waste any more time. It's time we told them we've got something to say. It's time we opened their eyes. It's time we told them that we won't be denied. Keep your eyes on the prize. Keep your eyes on the prize. Keep your eyes on the prize. Keep your eyes on the prize.
This time we have the children's group led by Sarah Hofstetter, song This Little Light of Mine, and all children are welcome to sing along.
So I bet a lot of you know this song, This Little Light of Mine. I've got the lyrics up here too. Here we go. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Can I get a kid on the mic? Everywhere I go, everywhere I go, I'm gonna let it shine. Everywhere I go, I'm gonna let it shine. Everywhere I go, I'm gonna let it shine, let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
All around the world.
All around the world, I'm gonna let it shine. All around the world, I'm gonna let it shine. All around the world, I'm gonna let it shine. Shine, let it shine, let it shine.
This little light.
This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
Let's see how many. This, thank you so much. Yeah. Next year, you get to market that year. Thank you so much.
We're going to have them come and join us and read these letters from Elizabeth Peratrovich.
One, a proper introduction, and two, a few words before we begin. These were actually prepared in advance, so not in response to anything today. But first, Akatas Aksanihas Yeshna Gunachish Haji Edi Ches Yukhatosa Tlingit Chena. Diane Benson, you cut to us off. Leitka, Renach. Yechna, Kratziti. Abdentan, Ayachat. Tachetach, Ayachat. Norwegian, Yadi, Ayachat. Shetkaquan, Dacha, Ayachat. So I come from Sitka originally. I a newcomer to Petersburg, but not in my spirit. People keep asking me, how come you moved to Petersburg? People from not Petersburg and people in Petersburg, so I've had to come up with an answer. So I said, my answer is, well, I'm half Tlingit, I'm half Norwegian, where else would I go? My grandmother on my father's side came off the boat from Norway. So, and I come to find out, you know, it's not unlike a fishing village there to here. So I could see the attractions. Plus, both groups are just very tough peoples and very good looking. Okay, so to say a few words, I just want to make sure that, especially with my Tlingit use and any words I say today, I mean no offense if I have said or done something incorrectly, because I am always learning, like all of us, we are always learning. Elizabeth Peratrovich, as everyone knows, was born here, and of the Lukakadi, there you go, clan, it's a Raven clan, in 1911. See, she was poised and elegant, a woman who was passionate about social issues, and she addressed such issues not just on discrimination, treatment of veterans, housing, and education, to name a few. So besides fighting for social justice throughout her life, she also worked for the legislature and the Juneau Credit Association. And she also represented Alaska Native interests with the National Congress of American Indians. So after the passage of the anti-discrimination bill, she actually had an opportunity going to an education conference to hear Martin Luther King speak, which of course was very validating and inspiring. So she was in many ways an ambassador for her people and to social justice in the world at large. But I want to say, as I have written here previous, working on it hard last night, Tlingit women have stood equally beside the men in Tlingit society. And Amy Hallingstad was a contrast to Elizabeth, with a more direct style, so I am informed, and addressed more regional issues, primarily subsistence, or really the protection of salmon for the people and of land rights. Another was Mildred Sparks, who was passionate about the culture and really fought for us to bring our songs and dances to life again in the face of oppression. They, along with many others, demonstrated that one person can make a difference and that we can all find a place, all of us, to ensure the rights and goodness of people anywhere. I just hope that all of us find that little part in us, you know, to stand up in defense of someone else, because we do have a lot of injustice in the world today. So, to demonstrate the times and some of the issues addressed by Elizabeth and Wright Peratrovich, young people will be reading a total of 3 letters with performances in between, and I am sure you will appreciate their willingness to stand before you to deliver these letters. We need to hear the voices of our young people. So first is a 1941 letter to the territorial governor, Greening, read by Adam Ware.
A sign on the door which reads, "No natives allowed." In the view of the present emergency, when unity is being stressed, don't you think that it's very un-American? We have always contended that we are entitled to every benefit that is accorded our so-called white brother. We pay the required taxes in some instances that we feel are unjust, such as the school tax. Our native people pay the school tax each year to educate the white children, yet they try to exclude our children from these schools. In the present emergency, our native boys are being called upon to defend our beloved country, just as the white boys. There is no distinct being made there, but yet when we try to patronize some businesses, establishments, we are told in most cases that natives are not the PR, the proprietor of Douglasson does not seem to realize that our native boys are just as willing as the white boys to lay down their lives to protect the freedom that he enjoys. This is from Mrs. Roy Peratrovich, Grand Vice President Annis, and Roy Peratrovich, Grand President of AMU.
That was a letter written December 30th, 1941.
Thank you, Adam. Can we give it up again for Adam for coming up? Sharon, it's great to hear from our youth. For them being able to share and share the history.
While our string friends are tuning, I'd like to say it is our shared honor to be here before you today and invited together in the honor, the work, the life, and the spirit of Elizabeth Peratrovich. Thank you so much. Thank you.
coincidence that your letter of December 30 should reach me today. The day before yesterday, I've taken up this very matter with Mayor Lucas and asked him to use his influence to have any sign indicating discrimination between Natives and whites removed. I have similarly written to the mayor of Anchorage. I'm asking the owner of the Douglas Inn to come and see me, and will do my best to have him remove the sign, No Natives Allowed, which I fully agree with you is offensive, contrary to American principles, and unjustified in every way. I will be glad to inform you as to the results. For your own information, I have never patronized the Douglas Inn, nor will I patronize any establishment where such discrimination is thus made a matter of public policy. Sincerely yours, Ernest Gruning, Governor of Alaska.
Thank you, Heather. Sheesh. At this time, we have the song Over the Rainbow performed by our sound man, Mark Kubo. Metallics. Thank you for sharing. Thank you for all your help with putting all the sound together. So, go ahead. Thank you, Mark.
So, you might wonder why I chose Over the Rainbow. So, the lyricist is Edgar Ebsel Harbert, also known as Yeet, the son of Jewish immigrants, known as Broadway's social conscience. He was a human rights activist, weaving into his lyrics themes of social justice, feminism, anti-war, and anti-racism. Yeet wrote all of the lyrics to The Wizard of Oz at a time of increasing anti-Semitism, mere years before the first shots of World War II. He saw in the story how the characters reflected basic human needs and how the characters were linked with each other. In an interview, he said, "The Wizard of Oz, on the surface, seems to be a childish fantasy, but it is far from that. It is the very basis of all our hopes and lives and things we live for. In this story, you meet a girl who misses her roots and wants to get home. You meet a tin man who would like to have a heart. You meet a lion who wants courage. And you meet a straw man who wants brains. What does it mean to have a heart? What does real courage look like? What does it mean to have brains? How do you get these things?" And that is the search underlying The Wizard of Oz. It's the same search that children and grown-ups continue to this very day. Over the Rainbow was central to Yeep's concept for the Oz film.
When all the world is a hopeless jumble and the raindrops
potatoes, that will
for me right now, because I have lost my best friend, my closest sibling, and I was asked if I would not be showing up here because of the grief of my family. But as a Tlingit, this has healing. Each day is is a struggle, but it's like, that's why we carry weight for each other. As Dakdain Tan, I like to think my Dakdain Tan family are, my clan are supporting me and my family through this difficulty. And I extend that, that's why this song touches me so much, because we're a human family. And gosh, haven't we said enough rude words to one another, And I'm just so utterly grateful that my last words to my brother were not rude. So the third letter, and that's one of the things, is when somebody actually has a gift to use words and use them in a powerful and meaningful way. That's what Roy and Elizabeth really did. That was their gift. Others had other gifts, and they used those. And it is this gift that produced some of these letters that got some people who could understand those words to do something. And here's a letter that was signed by Roy, but to my knowledge was also written by both of them. And Roy always said that he never did anything without her, and that she was usually kind of kicking him along. So, good thing at work. This letter will be read by Adriana Stau.
My Tlingit name is Gwaich, and I'm a Kiksuti from Wrangell, and this letter is on racial discrimination. Regulations prohibit any soldier from publicly associating with Indian girls. The inference drawn is that they are not decent Indian girls, and that the regulations are to protect the soldiers from contamination. We hold no brief for immoral Indian girls any more than for a white girl. We do not ask that uncontrolled association be permitted, but we do insist that there is a large group of Indian girls being insulted by classing them with the scum of the notorious dives of Juneau. The blood of these Indians is being expended to protect the civil, political, and property rights of foreign racials on foreign soil. These men who have been expended and who are being expended say to you, in dealing with their wives, sisters, and mothers, remember us. They say to you that their wives and sisters are entitled to the same rights as are being fought for in China, Europe, and Africa. I hope you look into this matter for the goodness and fairness of all. Respectfully yours, Roy Peratrovich, Grand Camp President.
Thank you, Adriana, and Ashish. At this time, we have the honor of being able to have Elizabeth's speech to the legislature, actually read by Diane Benson, that in a film that all of you should watch, she actually played the part of Elizabeth Peratrovich. So it's an honor for us to have her now living here with us, and her on Elizabeth Peratrovich Day to be able to say this speech. This is very emotional and moving, and we're honored that you're here. Diane, thank you. And we welcome you at this time to share Elizabeth's speech to the legislature.
I just flew in yesterday. I'm being with my family in Anchorage. Here's the good news. I'm not doing this alone. In fact, it's passing the torch. That's what this is all about. Us older folks have to make room for these younger voices and hold them up to be the voices that we need, because they have challenging things to face. So there we are. Where is Elizabeth in the territorial legislature? They've been fighting for this bill for a couple of years. They own the territorial legislature, only met every 2 years, and they hadn't passed it in 1943. Some have tried to minimize what that meant, but then you go another 2 years without the anti-discrimination bill. They had made progress, then they had to really kind of hustle and work hard to get people to get on board with this bill, with this act. And it takes allies. So there were a lot of non-Native peoples who were involved as well, who were allies to the cause. But during this, they were in the Senate, so it had passed the House now. And then those days, the gallery was where the Native people sat, so they couldn't even be in the main area with the non-Native people during the hearing for this. So this is the speech we're going to do as we make the transition symbolically. As I do part of the speech, and Avery takes over. I would not have expected that I, who am barely out of savagery, would have to remind gentlemen with 5,000 years of recorded civilization behind them of our Bill of Rights. When my husband and I came to Juneau, we sought a home in a nice neighborhood where our children could play happily with the neighbor's children, and we had arranged to lease it. When the owners learned that we were Indian, they said no. Would we be compelled to live in the slums? Even now, doors to schools are closed to our children, and signs make it quite clear that I, as well as dogs, are not allowed. Well, discrimination occurs in many ways, let me assure you. There are three kinds of persons who practice discrimination. First, the politician, who likes to make, who wants to maintain an inferior minority group so that he can always promise them something. And second, the Mr. and Mrs. Jones, who aren't quite sure of their social position, so are kind to you on one occasion and can't see you on the next, depending on who they are with. And third, the great Superman who believes in the superiority of the white race. Well, it is this kind of perpetuated thought that serves to separate and discriminate and has forced the finest of our race to associate with trash. And in response to Senator Shattuck's earlier question, do I believe that the passage of this bill will eliminate discrimination?
Do your laws prevent those crimes? No law will eliminate crimes, but at least you, as legislators, can assert to the world that you recognize the evil of the present situation and speak your intent to help us overcome discrimination. Overcome discrimination for all Alaskans.
Thank you.
you as well, Avery, for coming up. That was amazing that she was able to be a part of that, passing the torch. And if you'd like to watch this film, the name of it is For the Rights of All Ending Jim Crow in Alaska. You probably can't see that, but you can see there's Diane right there on the side. So she's famous right here. Wow. Well, at this time, I'd like to welcome our relative, Ross Nenick III, and he has a song, and you can stand with us if you'd like once he comes up. So, Ross, if you would come forward. Thank you.
My name is Tai Day. I am Sukti Nadi of the Cape Kwan. I come from the Tlingit. My clan, the Sukti Nadi, our crest is the dog salmon. It's the late fall dog salmon, swimming through the golden grasses of what is now Port Camden. Tlingit is the house I come from, and that is the house in tall grass. My name, Tai Day, translates out, has to do with my crest. They say when the tide is high, the dog salmon is all right. But when the tide goes out, he swims under the rocks. And that's my name, he swims under the rocks. The song we're going to be singing is Cha Ade Ye Una Ti Ga. This song belongs to the Lukahadi clan. And for a while, it was sung as our national anthem. But people forgot to introduce the song. It's one of our protocols is you must tell who owns the song, who gave you permission to sing the song. The current Hitsadi, Raymond Dennis Jr., is a friend of mine, and I asked him, can I sing the song? Can I use it? And he said, as long as you tell the story, you can use the song. The song was written by Auntie Aethli Hakashi of the Lukahadi. In the days, in the early days of the Europeans and Americans, he was traveling by canoe and he came upon a boat, and in the boat was a family that was all deceased. They'd all been killed and murdered. Being a good man, he towed the boat to an outpost, and not knowing the language and them not knowing his language, they thought he was the one that killed them. So they locked him up and put him away for many years. When he was released and he was going home, it had been many years, and in those times, much had befallen his people. Disease from alcoholism, from smallpox. So he was very saddened. And when he got back, he wrote this song. And when the Lukahadi people sang the song, they sang it as a mourning song. But when they released it in the late 80s, they released it as a unification song. It was to bring the people together. And that's what we'll do here. We're going to bring everybody together. So whether you stand in unification, whether you stand for somebody has passed, or whether you stand because it was once our national anthem, I'd like you to stand with me. Translation for the song, I can't remember all of it, but thanks to Diane, I do remember the first verse it has to do with so it is not forgotten on our grandfather's land. We will hear our voices on it.
Yeah.
All right, we've got closing comments. We have the Elizabeth Peratrovich Mural Project Chairperson. Exciting for our town, with a lot of you know what's going to be happening, some of you might not. I'd like to welcome Melina Marvin, if you can come forward. Chair,
is anyone getting hungry for the food back there? Okay, we're gonna get there right after this, so I'm only talking long enough, okay? I'm only talking long enough to raise some money. So the quicker the money is raised, the fewer the words from my mouth, and the quicker we get to the food. So we have these lovely ladies with some baskets, and as they start passing those around, I'm gonna tell you a little bit about one of the reasons we're here today. So, who here is on the Elizabeth Peratrovich Mural Project Subcommittee? Who's still here in the house? Will you guys stand up? Okay, these people. These amazing people have been meeting constantly, almost every week, for quite a while to help be good allies and help plan and support this event. As a bit of a fundraiser for a big portrait of Elizabeth Peratrovich that's going to go on the courthouse downtown, facing the downtown street. And so, looking at all this art that's on the stage, the portrait of Elizabeth, and all these amazing prints, these are all coming from the spirit of Janine Gibbons, who's going to be doing our mural. So what we're fundraising for here today is the paint and supplies and the commission of Janine's time, and the installation costs, a bronze plaque, right, that will commemorate Elizabeth Peratrovich along with the other people and events we have commemorated in the kind of social fabric of our community. So all that's going to take a little bit of money, right? We're trying to raise about $10,000, and we're about a quarter of the way there, and we have until May. So I'm asking you to dig a little bit deep, and if something moved you this afternoon, if you had feelings, and that meant something to you, I would really encourage you to make a meaningful gift to this project, because this is the work going forward of telling these stories and making these voices and faces a visible part of our community. We're probably going to have another fundraiser or two, and we do really encourage anyone who can and is inspired to make a major donation to do so. We would really love to raise the majority of our funds right here from our community to show that we value this incredible historical figure who was born here, or as Diane said, this is the place the Creator gave her life. Right? This is a big gift, and this is the year inspired by the release of this coin in her honor. This is the year for us to really step up and claim this famous person who's, you know, came from our community. So on behalf of the Arts Council and the Peratrovich Mural Subcommittee and the partnership that we've created with Petersburg Indian Association and A&B, ANS, we invite you to be part of the mural project and also to join us in May when we unveil the mural downtown during Little Norway Festival. It's going to be on Saturday around 2 p.m. And various dignitaries have been invited. We're going to have another dance group from Juno in town. It's going to be performing. We'll have another little potluck with refreshments. It's going to be really fun. And we are only going to be able to get there if we raise money and fill our budget. So thanks so much for your generosity. There's more papers explaining the mural project back here. You can grab one on your way out. And you could talk to any of us on the subcommittee, right, to learn more about it. And you're also welcome to join and help us plan as we go down the stretch and get this all figured out. And I will add that since this idea bubbled up from many corners of the community a few years ago, we have always thought that 2020 is the year because the Peratrovich coin comes out and it's the 75th anniversary of her speech. But we want this group to continue and to honor other leaders in our community, like Amy Hallingstad, into the future, maybe with also art projects. So thanks so much, everyone. We really are so grateful to you for being part of this project with us.
Well, there's a lot of people that helped put this day together. Can we put our hands together for Petersburg Indian Association, for A&B, A&S, and for the Petersburg Arts Council? A lot of time. Thank you, everybody. It's pretty great for us to have events where we can unify together under such a great cause. Well, at this time, we are very close to eating. But we would like to invite everybody, some of you are passing out, if you would stand up with us, and I'd like to welcome Sarah Hofstetter. She's going to lead us in singing We Shall Overcome. If you want to link hands or link arms or put a hand on our shoulder, however you'd like to do that, and we're going to sing this at this time. So Sarah, she here? All right. All right.
Closest to you. Well. Everyone elbow to elbow. This time is so cold and lonely and swimming. Okay. Everybody have time with someone? We shall overcome. We shall overcome. Someday.
shall all be free.
We shall all be free. We shall all be free. We shall all be free
shall overcome. We have overcome some things. We have things in the future. Let's unite together, stand together, look forward to next year and future things. At this time, what we'd like to do is, anybody hungry? Ready to eat? All right. Let's pray for our food, and then we're going to start digging in. What we would ask is elders first, please. So our elders will go first, and then from there, everybody else can follow behind. And then during the potluck, we'll have a time of open mic if you'd like to share something. So let's pray at this time. Lord, we just thank you for this time for us to gather together. God, to celebrate Elizabeth Peratrovich Day. God, the freedoms that we have today. God, we're thankful for this day that we were able to celebrate. We're able to hear from many people, and we're looking forward to the future of all the things that you're inspiring in our hearts, of how we can stand out and how we can begin to lead and be voices in our culture to our people. So God, we thank you for today. We thank you for this gathering of many of us uniting together. And we pray a blessing on the food and all the hands that prepared it. We pray that all in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Dig in.